Hi students, today we'll discuss about Hamming code, that is in unit 1, second part, okay, in digital electronics or in STLD. In the first unit we have a Hamming code topic. What is a Hamming code? Is nothing but it is error detection and correction code. Hamming code is error detection and correction code. So we are going to detect the errors and we'll correct that error. This is a single bit error detecting and correcting code. So here first we have to find the number of parity bits. So here we have to find in this Hamming code, the first aim is to find the parity bits. The formula is 2 power p is greater than or equal to x plus p plus 1. 2 power p is greater than or equal to x plus p plus 1. Here x is the message or information or data. You may take any manner. Okay. For example, I am transmitting 1101 like that. Whatever you are transmitting, that is called as a message or information or data. And P is the parity bits. The parity may be even parity or odd parity. He will mention. If he is not mentioning, you can take anyone. These are the parities. Then, for example, find the Hamming code for 1011 with even parity. Like that, he may ask. 1011 is the transmitted code. So, for this 1011, we have to find the Hamming code. For this Hamming code, first we can find the parity bits. The first step is find parity bits. The first step to find the Hamming code is we have to identify the parity bits. First step is find parity bits. Very, very important. First step is find parity bits. So formula is 2 power p is greater than or equal to x plus p plus 1. 2 power p is greater than or equal to what is x? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 bits. X is transmitted information or data or message. 4 bits we are transmitting. That's why X is equal to 4. X is equal to 4. Plus, we don't know P value. P plus 1. 4 plus 1, 5. So, 2 power P is greater than or equal to pi plus P. 4 plus 1, 5. Pi plus P. For example, I am substituting P is equal to 1 here. P is equal to 1. 2 power 1 is greater than or equal to pi plus 1. Is not satisfied. If I am substituting p is equal to 1, 2 power 1, that is nothing but 2. 2 is greater than or equal to 5? No. 2 is not greater than 5, first of all. 5 plus something is not possible. Then take p is equal to 2. 2 power 2 is nothing but 4. 4 is greater than 5? No. That is not possible. Then go for p is equal to 3. Check p is equal to 3. 2 power 3 is 8. Greater than or equal to 5 plus 3, 8. 8 is equal to 8. Greater than or equal to. So greater than is not possible here. 8 is equal to 8. That's why P is equal to 3. I am taking P is equal to 3 as a parity bits. So total bits in Hamming code is X plus P. Total bits in Hamming code is X plus P. X is data bits. 1011 4 bits. Plus P is the parity bits. Parity bits are 3. 4 plus 3 is 7. 7 bits. So this 1011 information, total number of bits in the Hamming code is 7. For 4 bit information, the Hamming code is 7 bit code. 7 bit code simply. So here the first thing is find parity bits. Second thing is location of parity bits in the Hamming code. We know that is having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bits. 7 bits. Okay, it is having 7 bits like this. In these 7 bits locations, 4 bits are message bits. Remaining 3 bits are parity bits. That's why we have to find the parity locations. Location of the parity bits in Hamming code. So the second step is find the location of the parity bits. So location of the parity bits are 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2 and so on, 2 power n. Here 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3 and so on are the parity locations. So that means 2 power 0 is 1. 2 power 0 is 1. 2 power 1 is 2. 2 power 2 is 4. And 2 power 3 is 8 and so on. 1, 2, 4, 8, 16 and so on. Those are the parity locations. Parity locations. Then for 4 bit data, for 4 bit data, the Hamming code is having 3 parity plus 4 data bits, total 7 bit Hamming code. I am taking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 bit code. And data is So d7, d6, d5, d3, and parities are 2 power 0 means 1. First location is parity, and 2 power 1 is 1 is 2 power 1 is 2. Second location is also parity, 2 power 2 is 4. Fourth location is also parity. Remaining are data information for this code. For example, we have another parity, 2 power 3. Eighth location is the parity bit. Here we don't have 8th bit, that's why I'm not taking that. So 1, 2, 4 are the parity locations. That's why I'm taking P1, P2, P3. P1, P2, P3 are the parity locations. Then data is 1011 he has given already. So here 1011 data he has given. So 1011. Otherwise, first you can write D7, D6, D5, D3. This order I'm writing. Bits order is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Bits order. That's why D3 means data here, D5 means data, D6 is a data, 7th location also data, like that. If you want, you may take any manner, no problem, no problem. So any order you can take. Any order means D1, D2, D3, D4, P1, P2, P3, like that. Anyway you can take, no problem. Otherwise P1, P2, P4 you can take, no problem. In some textbooks it was taken like this, 4th location is a parity, so P4. And second location is parity P2, first location is parity P1, like that he is taking. As you wish, you can take in any manner. Then after this, go for third one. Assigning values to the parity bits. Assigning values to the parity bits. So we are saying that P1, P2, P3 are the parity locations. What is P1 locations? First we have to identify. P1 locations we have to identify. For that purpose, I am taking decimal number and corresponding binary number. Taking decimal number and corresponding binary number. Decimal corresponding binary. How many bits we have? 7 bits. So up to 7 is enough for us. Up to 7 is enough. But the decimal number I was taking, that's why I am taking from 1 to 9. So 0th location is not there, that's why I am not taking 0. 1 to 7, 7 bits, that's why 1 to 7 is enough. 1 to 7 is enough. So here 1 to 7. For if you have 8 and 9 also, what is the parity location? So that's why I am taking 1, binary is 0001, 2, 0010, binary number I am writing, 4 bit binary number, and 3, 0011, 4, 0100, 5, 0101, 6, 0110, 7, 0111, 8, 1000, 9, 1001. Now, the parity locations, assigning the values of parity bits, parity locations are P1, where we have high, that corresponding bits we have to write. This is high. Okay, what is the location? 1. Here is a high, that is 3. Here is high, 5. Here also high, 7. Here also high, 9. So 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 and so on. So here up to 7 is enough. Why? Because I have only 7 bits. My maximum number is 7. So that's why I'm taking up to 7. If it is having 8, 9, 10, 11 so on, you can take all the numbers. Then parity locations are increases. So here for P1, where we get P1 high, those corresponding locations we have to take. That is a 1, 3, 5, 7. 1, 3, 5, 7. P1 locations. In the same manner P2. P2 where we are getting high. Here is high. Corresponding number is 2 and 3 and 6, 7. 2, 3, 6, 7. 2, 3, 6, 7. And go for the third parity. Third parity, this is third parity. So here 4, 5, 6, 7. 4, 5, 6, 7. Here we are not taking fourth parity. So this is not required. Why? Because I have 7 bits only. If I have 8 bits, 8th bit also parity bit. That's why I can take P4 also. P4 and these numbers are from whatever we have the maximum number. So here we have only 3 parity bits, that's why I am taking P1, P2, P3, and only 7 bits we have, I am taking 1 to 7. There, for that I am writing binary number, there we are getting P1 high, P2 high, P3 high, those locations. 1, 3, 5, 7, P1, P2, 2, 3, 6, 7, P3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then, next step, this is the last step, fourth one. First step parity bits, second step parity locations, third step parity positions, where we have parity positions. Okay, then using even parity. So he has mentioned already with even parity. Find the Hamming code for 1011 with even parity. That's why I'm taking that even parity. So first I'm writing P1 locations are 1357. 1357 from this table. P1. So in our Hamming code, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bits. P1 and data you can write here. So data is 1011. He has given 1011. D71 and D60 and D51, D4, D31. Remaining bits are parity bits. P1, P2, P3. P1 is 1357. First location bit is P1. In the first location, what is the bit we have? Parity bit, P1. And third location. Third location is D3. What is D3? 1. D3 is 1. D3 is 1. 1011 we have. D3 is 1. If you want, you may take directly this as 1. D3 as 1. And fifth location. Fifth location is 1. 1. Fifth location is 1. 1011 bit. Fifth location is 1. And seventh location is also 1. P1, 1, 1, 1 we have. So in even parity is asking. Using even parity, find the Hamming code. Even parity is nothing but in this bits, in this 1357 locations, how many number of ones we have, we can observe. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 3 ones only we have. 3 is our even parity or odd parity? Odd parity. 3 number of ones are there. Ones 3 we have, that is an even number. By taking P1, by taking which number P1, it is becoming as even. For example, I am taking 0, 0, then number of ones are 3 only, that is an odd parity, but he has given even parity. That's why P1 must be 1. If you take P1 1 here, 1, 1, 1, 1, that is a 4 ones we have. 4 ones means even parity. 4 is nothing but even parity. Number of ones should be even number. So if P1 is 0, that is odd parity. So that's why we have to consider P1 as 1. Then only it is an even parity. So P1 should be 1. P1 should be 1. Then go for P2. 2367. 2367. Second location is again parity. P2. 3 is a 1. And 6 is a 0. 7 is 1. This P2, 1, 0, 1. Then again you can find the number of ones. We have 1, 2. 2 ones we have. 2 ones we have. 2 is even number. 2 is even number. For example, I am taking P2, 0. Okay, even number. P2, 1 I am taking. Then 3 ones we have. That becoming as odd parity. That's why P2 should be 0. By making P2 either 0 or 1, we have to find even parity. By doing what value, we will get the even parity, that we have to do. So if I am taking P2 0, then this is an even parity. If I am taking P2 1, that is odd parity, but he has given even parity. That's why P2 should be 0. Then go for last one, P3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Fourth one is again P3, parity bit, P3, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1. P3, 1, 0, 1. What are the number of ones here? 2 ones we have. 1, 1. 2 ones we have. 2 is an even number. So P3 should be 0. P3 should be 0. That's why P3 should be 0. Then the 7-bit Hamming code is, you can write 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1. What is P3? P3 is 0. You can write P3 as 0. And next, D3 is 1, D3 is 1, and P2 is 0, P2 is 0, this is P2, and P1 is 1, P1 is 1. So 1010101 is the 7-bit Hamming code. 1010101 is the 7-bit Hamming code. In this way, we can find the Hamming code for any number of bits. Again, I'm repeating within 1 minute. See here. In Hamming code, if you want to find the Hamming code, first we can find the parity bits. The first step is we have to find the parity bits. 2 power p is greater than or equal to x plus p plus 1. And next step is find the location of the parity bits. So those are 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3. Based on that, you can write number of bits and first find the Hamming code bits, then find the parity locations, then parity values where we have the parities. P1 location is 1, 3, 5, 7. If you are increasing that, 1, 3, 5, 7, comma 9, comma 11, comma and so on, you will get. You can observe, no problem. You can observe. So for this problem, 1, 3, 5, 7 only we are taking for 7-bit Hamming code. And in the same manner, for those locations, you can take even parity or odd parity. For example, if you take odd parity, those will be changed. Here, even parity we are taking, that's why number of 1 should be even number. So, if P1 I am taking 1, then only there should be even number. 4 ones we have even number, then P1 should be high. Here, number of 1s are 2. If I am taking P2 1, that become odd parity. That's why P2 should be 0. Then P3 also 0. So, in those parity locations, I am writing the parity bits. Data bits already we know, 1, 0, 1, 1. In place of P3, I am writing what is P3 0. And in place of P2, that is also 0. And in place of P1, that is 1. Okay, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. That is the 7-bit Hamming code. In the next class, we will find the errors, error detection and correction. This is the Hamming code. Next, go for the how to find the error location and how to correct it. Okay, that is the last topic. Thank you.